Uh-huh. Oh, I understand lab procedure. I happen to be a nurse. I was just really hoping you could give me the test results over the phone. Okay, I will look for the envelope in the mail on Thursday. Thank you.
Hi.
What's going on? Who got tested?
It was just lab work for a critical patient. I was trying to put a rush on things.
No, it's fine. Yeah, you don't have to tell me. It's none of my business. I don't know why I asked.
Excuse me.
Yeah. Look, Elizabeth, last time we spoke, it felt like I was kind of dropping a bomb with the whole green card marriage thing, and look, you have every right to be concerned about how my marriage to Siobhan might affect our kids.
Lucky, I understand that you would never purposely do anything to hurt Cameron or Jake.
That's the truth.
So, other than picking up the kids for Daddy's night, is there something else you want to talk about?
Actually, yeah, I can't. Something's come up.
Why? They were really looking forward to it.
I know. I was too, but I, like I said, something's come up and it's unexpected. And not completely unexpected. I mean, we knew it could happen, but we just weren't specifically planning on tonight.
Okay, Lucky, you're scaring me. What's going on?
No, it's nothing awful. Nothing like, you know, life-threatening or anything. It's just, Siobhan and I, we, made the appointment to get married.
Sorry about that.
No, it's fine. You're at work. I don't mind waiting. But listen, we need to figure out who's going to watch the kids tonight because Siobhan's on her way to pick me up.
Yeah, I don't know what to tell you, Lucky. You should have run this by me first. I don't have anyone else to watch the kids.
I know. It's last minute. Maybe Audrey is available.
She's already at her book club tonight.
What am I supposed to do? I mean, take them with me?
Oh, I don't think so.
Hey.
Hello, Elizabeth. You ready to do this?
Yeah, there's some logistical difficulties.
He means his sons. Lucky, those boys have experienced enough upheaval in their lives. Please don't subject them to a sham of a marriage between a stranger and their father.
Well, it's neither my desire nor intention to cause harm to your kids.
I think we're all in agreement about that.
Cameron and Jake are at impressionable ages. I have tried really hard to keep their world secure and stable. They don't need a stepmother just popping up out of nowhere, especially one who's using their father to subvert immigration laws.
Well, the boys, they have no idea about my immigration status, if that's really what you're objecting to.
Cam and Jake are resilient kids, you know? They've never had a stable family from the beginning. Besides, they like Siobhan.
You are so caught up in all this, you can't even see that you're drop-kicking your family.
Oh my God, I'm sorry. Who are you to accuse Lucky of anything? Were you thinking of Cam and Jake when you were screwing his brother every chance you got?
You don't have to keep apologizing.
I feel like I set you up or something. I mean, I knew Elizabeth would be opposed to us getting married, and that was just a stupid move for me to ask you to pick me up at the hospital.
Well, I survived the encounter with minimal damage. So your ex is no shrink and violet. She calls them just as she sees them.
Yeah, believe me, I wanted to stop it before it went too far.
Well, I appreciate my tendency to rescue, but I can hold my own against women scorned.
Yeah.
Elizabeth, it's ballsy, though, bringing your kids into it.
Yeah, well, you know, Elizabeth is right to be concerned about how our marriage might affect Cam and Jake. I mean, they've been through a lot already.
No, we don't have to go through with this.
Yeah, we do, unless we're okay with you being deported.
Well, maybe my immigration situation shouldn't be the priority.
Look, Cam and Jake like you, Siobhan. I mean, it's not going to be the end of the world having you as a stepmother.
Well, their mother doesn't think so.
You just have to understand where Elizabeth is coming from. I mean, she's alone for the first time in her life. And that's a scary place to be, so I'm going to cut her some slack.
Might I go a bit deeper than that?
What do you mean?
I'm thinking that you still might have feelings for Elizabeth.
Elizabeth and I mean, we've been through so much together. But we can never figure out how to how to grow without growing apart. I mean, we both help each other through some really difficult times in our lives. And I'll always have a place for her in my heart. She'll always be the mother of my sons. But living in the past, that's the surest way to waste your life.
It's almost convincing.
I don't have any hesitancy about marrying you, so if you do, speak now or forever hold your peace.
I'm good.
You're good. Like I said, if we were in a perfect world, you know, we'd go about this another way. We'd take time to figure out what we mean to each other.
Well, perfection is an illusion. It's all gonna work with what you got.
Dad.
Hey.
Hello.
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 Something wrong?
Women are ruining my life.
Trouble with Tracy?
Oh, Tracy's a picnic compared to tonight. This headache is courtesy of your adorable cousin, Caroline, and the spineless Natasha.
That's Carla and Alexis. Well, hey, Dad, I have a way for you to refocus your energies.
I suppose it's too much to hope that you're running a scam.
Well, there's certainly an element of that at work.
Oh. Well, then you came to the right place. Tell me more.
Siobhan and I have an appointment tonight with a justice of the peace. We need a witness, so since I had the honor of standing up for you at your wedding, I was hoping that you would return the favor.